What's up, my fellow citizens? I'm Citizen Kev. Today, we're going to talk about dating. So have you ever tried to court, but you don't have any cash? Or want to date, but you don't have any dollars? I'm pretty sure unless you're born with a silver spoon in your mouth, all of us have been there. Let's be real, it's a trash place to be in whenever you know you want to go out and spend quality time with that person, but you don't exactly have all the funds that you need. You might not have the funds just because you are saving up for a nice vacation, you might have a wedding that you're trying to pay for, you might be paying off a car or doing something special. Regardless of whatever it is, having slim pockets is no fun. The way that Citizen Rissa and I get in some quality time is by actually going to the museum. The local Dallas Arts Museum, it's either free to cheap, depending on what exhibits you want to see. And from what I've noticed, most other cities are kind of the same way. Some of the benefits from going to a museum are, if things are going kind of awkward, you can just walk away and it won't seem rude. You'll just look like you're kind of interested in another piece of art. Seeing all the different pieces of history and art actually just gives you easy topics to talk about. You don't even really have to come up with stuff. You can just look, point, and ask someone, what do they think? And if you don't have any like input on that particular piece, walk 10 feet and I'm sure you'll find something else. Going to the museum and asking your date about whatever piece of art that you're looking at, it can kind of give you insight on how they think. I'm not sure I would take someone out to the museum as like our first date unless they're just a huge history buff, but it can make for an interesting date if you've already been with that person, if you're already comfortable with one another. It's a great way to just hang out, enjoy each other's time, and just really get to know each other. Even if you already know each other, you can still just talk. The most expensive part of your date, honestly, would probably be the food. To get around that, to not even spend a whole bunch of money for food, I would recommend either going to a food truck, which can be expensive, but you most likely won't just buy a whole bunch of things because you see it. Also, you can go to a non-chain restaurant. A non-chain restaurant would typically give you more authentic food, and it's also not going to be as expensive. Also feels more unique and special than just going to your typical insert whatever chain restaurant you like going to. They'll be wowed by this unique place that you took them to, and you guys hopefully will just grow closer. Or you might grow farther apart. I mean, if it's a terrible day, it's just a terrible day. Here's some of the video from the Dallas Arts Museum that Citizen Rissa and I went to.
Kevin.
Right now, we're in the American art section, but to me, this looks like something out of Aladdin. I don't know. Tell me what you think in the comment section. So I'm a lot more into like sculptures and stuff. Tapestry, nah. Sculptures and masks and things over looking at paintings and stuff. So this is the world's largest horseshoe. It was a way that they were able to test to see who the strongest warriors were. No, I'm just kidding. I have no clue what this is, but it looks kind of cool. Alright guys, if you like this kind of video, just let me know. Drop a comment down in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm thinking about possibly even doing a series on not cheap dates, just dating on a budget. Let me know what you guys think about that. Until I see you next week, don't forget to do good, be good, and feel good. I'll catch you later.